Quiggan continues his stirring comeback against Thomas DeCruz at Super Featherweight. A fight you can see exclusively on ITV tonight. Dickie Davis reports now from Kenilworth Road.
Well, it's another June outdoor adventure for Bally McGuigan. 3 years ago at Queen's Park Rangers, he beat Eusebio Pedroza to win the WBA featherweight title. And today, here at Luton Town's ground, he faces the Brazilian Thomas DeCruz. A good win, and he could get another crack at a world championship. As you can see, the final preparations are almost complete. The setting is going to be absolutely superb. Over 15,000 fight fans are expected, and that means well over £1 million. Such is the interest in this fight, it's going to be seen live in America. Barry has been training in the peaceful surroundings of Henlow Grange, the Hertfordshire health farm where he's been based for the last 5 weeks. He was in a very relaxed frame of mind as I joined him for his daily stroll by the riverside. And afterwards he told me that he was in the pursuit of excellence.
I'm looking this time to be more accurate, more on the ball. And obviously you always want that perfect round. Just like Alain Prost wants the perfect lap, I want the perfect round and being able to throw perfect punch and or the perfect punches.
Well, Thomas DeCruz is the world number four. Do you think you're being a trifle ambitious in taking him in just your second fight back?
If I'm going to be champion again, I've got to beat the best. And he's a big junior lightweight. I picked him because he's big, he's strong, he's number four, and he's number three in the other, or number four in the other ratings as well. So he's a world-class fighter. He's got an impeccable record. And if I'm going to be champion again, I'm going to have to beat boys like this. That's the reason I've got. It's going to be a very tough fight for me. I'm not underestimating him in any way. But I've got to beat fellas like this if I'm going to be champion again.
Could you explain how crucial this fight is to you?
This is a very important fight to me. It's very, very important. It's a step further. It's a step nearer the title. It's a step closer to regaining something that I've always wanted, that I should never have lost. And it's very, very important.
And your strategy for the fight?
I wouldn't be giving away any clues because I believe he can speak a bit of English and I'm sure he'd probably be listening. So all I'm saying is I'm ready to fight. I'm prepared in every department. He said that he's ready to fight me whatever way I wanted, whether I want to go slam bag from the start or make it a longer fight, he's ready for me. All I can say to him is he better be ready. I'm going to win. And I'm going to win in style, and I hope that whoever out there are in two minds about buying a ticket will go and buy the ticket and come along and see me, because I need all their support. It's going to be a fantastic night, and I want to add to it by winning.
So you can see how important this fight is to the Clonus Cyclone. He's very happy with his training, he's in supreme condition, and he's confident about the fight. He's calling it a semi-final for a world championship, and you can see it with us on ITV tonight.
Absolutely right. But next
new is Kenilworth Road in Luton. Let's join Jim and Reg for the second round.
Oh, he's really got him on the hook here. This will be a really good performance, and he can do him in the second, and it looks like he's going to, because he's trying to cover up the cruise and he won't go down. He did this with Chavez, but now will Larry O'Connell give him every chance to come back? Yes, it looks as though he will. And he's fighting his way back. He's a gutsy guy. Because that really was a good salvo of shots there coming in from McGuigan.
He also came back with a good punch of his own. That was a solid hook that landed high in McGuigan's head. Certainly plenty of courage and a good chin, as his manager said before the fight.
Now we're coming up to the end of the second.
The punches going through here, very accurate, very solid all the way through. Doesn't leave the cruise alone. Little bit of success, and Barry really opens up.
Minute to go in round three. Doubling up the punches again. He's looking to the corner, the cruise, Jim. That's a bad sign. He's looking for a way out here. Shall I go? He's holding on. He's brave enough there, and it looks as though he's dying for the referee to come in, because at this point he is not throwing punches back, or is he going to do as he did in the previous round? Soak it up and then try and come back.
If he doesn't throw something back, referee O'Connell's going to have to move in. He's doing nothing.
He's so wild too, Cruz, when he comes back. It's all desperation stuff right above us now. And it's a question, surely, how long Larry O'Connell's prepared to let this fellow take. He's not taking them all on the chin, and saved by the bell again, and falls into O'Connell's arms. But it's a long haul back for this fellow.
I think McGuigan punched all the fight out of Cruz in that round. Cruz was looking over at his own corner, looking for some help, looking for some advice, and none was forthcoming
into round four. And it really is a world-class performance now by Barry McGuigan. This man's rated WBC number four, IBF number five. Have identical records. They're both 27 years old. It looks so much of an even match on paper, but there you go. Home ground advantage now for McGuigan. He only lives a left hook away from the Luton ground. Love the way he stands right in front of the cruiser. He's not scared to get inside punches, Jim. That takes a bit of doing.
No, well, this is the old McGuigan. We wondered if we would get him back again, but we do have him back again because everything is as it was before. Good attack, good punches, good power, and good defence. It's really an excellent performance so far from McGuigan.
McGuigan really looking for that big finisher. He'd like this one to have the sort of finality of a gunfight, wouldn't he? That's the way back to show the Americans that I'm ready. And they're going right above us, and he really is showing the distress signals now in the fourth round. And yes, it's all over. There was inevitable finish, because even in his own corner there, De Cruz and the referee being compassionate with him as McGuigan jumps into the arms of his brother, who's always first in the ring, the ejector suit brother, I call him, with the trainer Jimmy Tibbs, who said he's never trained such a more competent fighter in his life as this fellow. And Barry's back definitely in world class after that.
Well, Barry McGuigan's manager, Frank Warren, has been over in Atlantic City negotiating that world title fight against Azuma Nelson. Those negotiations are still very much in their early stages, but I understand the signs are good.